Spirit, a Yamaha scooter, but that had an appeal of a motorcycle. And of course, last but definitely not the least, Harley Davidson. And what a rocking star they have. They've got two new, the Street Bob and the Super Glider. So two new CKDs being introduced in India, about 10 lakh rupees, it'll cost you a pop. But for 1,600 cc's, that's of course a money well spent. So we'll talk about this. We'll also talk about how we are witnessing a bursting forth of so many mini SUVs, smart green SUVs. Is that the future? Well, perhaps Auto Expo showed that to us. But before that, let me go across to Dilip Chavaria. Many thanks, sir, for joining us here on Headlines today. What we want to know from you is that you launched a brilliant car today, the Avanti. Amitabh Bachchan came and inaugurated it. But for once, perhaps even Amitabh Bachchan was not the center of attention, it was the car. Just take us through exactly the thinking, the philosophy behind this amazing car. And is this time Dilip Chavaria only designing, or is he actually manufacturing and selling a supercar?
Okay, you know, to state it upright, this is the transformation of the company from a bespoke design or a custom builder to a specialist car manufacturer. So the car will go through its paces of regulation and what have you. So it's going to be like any other car produced in the world. Having said that, you know, we as companies always have to look out for segments to grow. Primarily segments where a manufacturer will not or cannot enter.
Okay.
Will not because of viability, cannot because of skills or whatever. And this was one segment where we felt with the increasing lifespan that Indians have,
yes,
the fact that your luxury car segment costing 25, 30 lakhs is 22,000 units this year, costing cars costing 1 crore and above are 1,000 numbers this year. We felt that, you know, if we could really engineer and create a car that for all purposes really competed with the Ferraris and Lamborghinis,
yes,
of the world in the truest sense, from the dimensions,
but
quality,
fit,
and finish.
Competing with a Ferrari or a Lamborghini, then obviously Indians will say, kitne ka? I'm not saying mileage kitna deti hai.
Yeah.
I'm just saying how much. A lot of cars that we saw today, the manufacturers were not willing to give us a figure because it's a concept car. You're saying this is not a concept car,
no,
this is a reality. How much?
I'm saying 25 lakhs. I'm saying if you disregard that the Ferrari comes with double the power, which you're never going to use in any case. In fact, no Ferrari's power can be used anywhere in the world because it's illegal to do
yes.
so. So having said that, if a customer can get that kind of a car for 25 lakhs, I think it makes a good business case, and that's what we are hoping for.
And Amitabh Bachchan, brand ambassador of Avanti?
No, he's not a brand ambassador. He's not a brand ambassador because he's already endorsing some other brand. But the point is, we wanted to have him to reach wide and far to people like you, because the media is starstruck from Bollywood perspective. There's no denying that. Because it is such an important announcement from DC Designs point of
yes.
view. We are trying to tell you loud and clear, we are becoming car manufacturers from now on.
For 25 lakhs, you're
exactly.
going to sell that dream car. That is unbelievable. Believe it or not, but the car that we just showed to you, Dilip Chavaria tells us that it could be yours for 25. Don't even look at a Ferrari then, and you're definitely never going to use that kind of horsepower. That is the car that you should honestly go for. Also, what are the cars that you can go for in the near future? Well, guess what? The definite cars that will be hitting the streets would be the smart compact SUV. Gone are the diesel, petrol guzzling days of cars, it seems, because SUVs, people want them, but they want them shorter, they want them smarter, they want them more environment friendly. And that is what we have seen car manufacturers responding to. Maruti, perhaps in a long, long time, after the Swift, perhaps, has come out with a brilliant concept car called the Exa. It's amazing to look at. And there is, of course, a very interesting philosophy behind it. It has the philosophy of the Indian wrestler. Interlocking design, aggression is there. And that car continues, however, to be a concept as of now. But Maruti is saying that they are very, very serious about getting this car onto the roads. Depending on the kind of response that they can get from the street, they would like to get that car onto the road. Also, what we saw is the Mahindra Rexton, which, of course, they have developed developed with SsangYong. Now, Mahindra Rexton is also a very interesting design philosophy, but nothing too radical. So you would be seeing it on the streets very soon. There is nothing radical about that. But I must mention here that Mahindra had another car, the X1V, which was very interesting to look at. Clearly goes to show that Mahindra is using the design philosophy from SsangYong and getting more cars in. Hyundai also had the Hexa Space, very interesting design. You can configure the seats as you want. Very futuristic build, very lightweight body. But Hyundai says that that car still continues to be a little bit of a design philosophy. And then, of course, another reality that would be hitting the streets very soon, you might want to seriously consider this car, Ford EcoSport. The EcoSport is also Ford's one of the lower cost designs. So you're going to see a lot more SUVs come into that 10 lakh plus range. You've already seen what Mahindra XUV has done. Bookings for a year, they've actually had to close down the bookings. Before I let Dilip Chavaria go, one final question. Besides your car, and I'm putting this quotation here, besides your car, what was the most interesting launch in terms of design and in terms of consumer interest in Auto Expo, according to you?
I haven't looked around, but from what I hear from my friends and pundits within the auto industry, I think clearly is the
that
Ford
car seems to have
created a lot of interest.
Okay, and before we go into a short break, I also want to know from you the broader aspect. You've seen a lot of auto expos. Yeah. Are you happy the way things are going? Because I'm told 1,500 exhibitors, 200 exhibitors weren't even allowed to come in because there's lack of space now. So are we marching towards that biggest tag in terms of, and most important, because Detroit is also happening at this point of time, many people did not come. Are we coming to an age where perhaps people will give Detroit a miss and not New Delhi?
I think in that some sense it's already happening. I think probably, and Yogendra probably would correct me, I think from a gate attendance point of view, it is probably the second largest show already after China. So, and with the levels of growth and the interest that one has in the automotive sector, I won't be surprised if the next time's Auto Expo is going to be even bigger, bolder. But having said that, I think you're right, the infrastructure. I mean, we ourselves asked for much more space than we got, and we were actually rationed.
Okay.
So that I think the powers that be need to look at that, because we are hampered with this space issue.
Yogendra, your pick?
Of the cars that were...
Of the cars that
Of course, the Ford EcoSport is the best car in terms of technology, in terms of what they're going to do with the price and making it affordable, in terms of an exciting design, although the SUV concept from Maruti also comes very close.
Yes.
And apart from that, as far as absolutely new cars are concerned, I mean, there's nothing that is extraordinary. Hmm. But Hyundai, with its fluidic... design philosophy, is getting new cars, and the Sonata will be the next car on the road.
I must ask you this. Last time around in Auto Expo, I would say that there was a lot more anticipation because of one car. Nobody had laid their eyes on the Nano, and everybody wanted to see what the Nano is of. This time, perhaps, there was a lot of launches that we already knew what the design philosophy was all about. Designed-wise, was last Auto Expo a little better because of the Nano, would you say?
I won't say the Nano defines the design paradigm in that sense. Maybe there was a lot more interest because of the affordability factor, but in hindsight, have you seen the way Nano has gone? I mean, there's no interest at all in that product. But I think as India progresses and evolves, and you've seen domestic auto manufacturers coming up to spec, you know, in that sense.
Okay.
So I would presume from the design perspective, this Auto Expo would be better. Though I haven't gone around, but I'm only talking aloud from the progress that...
I'm sure you'll find some time to go around. I know you've been very, very busy. Of course, Dilip, many thanks for joining us here. But clearly, there is a lot to go around in the next few days. The general public hasn't even been allowed to come in, and we saw such a lot of interest amongst business people, amongst the media, and there has been a packed audience as far as this is concerned. Many thanks, sir, for joining us here. But we take a very, very short break. We continue with Yogendra. We'll be right back. Stay with us here on Headlines Today.